My expectations for the boat trip were pretty high because like I saw some of the footage of Super Suck and can be pretty excited about getting the possibility of 10 or 20 second barrels. It's a pretty luxury yacht, so I was pretty amped to be on it with such a good crew of guys. And I guess I just expected everyone to surf really good and the stand to be super high, which it was, and just ended up being a really fun trip. Thank you. I sort of knew I could get good, and I was hoping that we'd get swell, so I'd get to see the full potential. And just pretty amped that we actually did. It was pretty rare to get that spot, that big for 3 days straight, so pretty amped on it. So amped because it started raining because we hadn't seen rain for so long, and all the tarpaulins were just filling up with water. But everyone like grabbed this soap and started soaping up and shampooing and jumping around. Everyone got pretty excited, and it's pretty crazy. Sort of after the sun, or just when the sun was going down, we'll come together and cruise out the front of the boat, sort of just sit down and everyone would just talk about the waves from that day or just stories of experiences they've had. Or it's pretty cool because it was like sitting around a campfire or something like that. It's a good time to get to know everyone a lot better. But that sort of sticks in the head is a really good experience in the trip.
Oh, he's too deep.
I've been kind of messing around with Mike Hammy, just filming spots here and there. When I was in Australia, I was filming some of the contests a little bit, some of the Shark Island contests. Just kind of trying to get the feel for it, I'm kind of still pretty much a rookie. I used it in Indo. We went on our experiment trip. I filmed a couple waves from the boat, just messing around, a couple waves of Roach from behind the scenes, I guess. Just kind of cool, like a cool angle I got of him on a couple little waves. Pulled back, kind of fun, you know? Instead of watching, now I can actually shoot and share with everyone what I see, you know, when I'm on trips. It's kind of cool. To do something kind of different, you know. I mean, I like riding waves a lot, but I also like, you know, to share that experience with other people. And I remember when I first saw just helmet cam point of views for the first time. People don't really get to experience that, you know, just from watching the video. And right now, it's really good for me because, you know, sometimes riding waves gets boring. You know, I mean, I've been doing it for so long. This is something kind of fresh and new for me. So I get like, I get motivated to go out and, you know, do something different. We were out at Chopo this one day, and I just remember taking off on this one, and I thought there was a chance of me making it. I got to the bottom, and I just knew like immediately that there was no way I was going to make it, and it was pretty cool because I just saw the whole lip throw out, and it was a decent barrel, and I got rocked pretty hard on it. My head got just rolled around, and when you got that camera on your neck, it's... I mean, it doesn't weigh too much. It's maybe, you know, 3 pounds, maybe 4 pounds, maybe. You get that thing on your head, and it's just like, whoa, you got all this extra weight. I'm getting jarred by a wave, and my head is just getting ripped all over the place. And I realized right then and there that, you know what, I can't really be messing around with this thing.
The North Shore this year has been pretty bad. There's been a couple days, but the pattern's just been totally, like, weird lately. I think there's no swells in October, and everything's just shifted, like, a month later. So we're in December right now, and the winds are howling, and it's raining a lot, and hasn't really been that many good days, but there's been a couple heavy days of pop. Everyone's just been getting kind of bored and going crazy. Swell that just come up, the buoys were like 11, 18 around there, and it was a new swell and it was super heavy, doubling up like on the sand. When we first checked it, we thought, no, there's no way you could ride this. And then I went out there and I skimboarded on a couple, and I went out without fins and caught a couple without fins and got pretty worked. And then I saw Mitch Rawlins went out and tried to catch a couple like big sets that were coming through with fins, and he got pretty worked on one big one, and then I just grabbed his fins and went out and tried to get a couple. me and Mitch were getting a couple of big ones, then I guess a whole bunch of other kids saw us getting a few, and they got excited to get some, so those guys were charging pretty hard. They were going for it, but it was really hard to make the wave, so they, most of them would just end up just free-falling 6 feet away onto dry sand and just getting totally wet. So yeah, they were going for it. It's good.
Waves have been crappy for a while, and everyone just amped to be in the water again. These guys are taking off in like 5-6 foot waves on the beach, just getting absolutely annihilated. It's pretty entertaining to watch. I saw Mitchell get a bomb, got absolutely slapped. Andre got a couple beasts. I mean, you can really pay the price out there, even though it's sand on the bottom. I learned the hard way. I was out there body surfing. Got absolutely tossed on a wave and end up hitting some kid in the head with my elbow that I didn't even know was out. Just popped up next to me and my elbow almost went through his skull. I came back and my elbow was just totally beginning. But it was a fun day. I've never seen some guys get absolutely worked, but it's definitely entertaining.
San Diego, we had no idea what lay ahead of us. We had a 4-hour flight to Atlanta, after that, a 6-hour layover, then we flew to Santiago. So it took us a good 35 hours at least to get here, but it was well worth it. Being on this trip was sick. We'd wake up and we could see the water from our house. We'd get up and walk a couple blocks, check this left, see how that was doing. And we'd just see all the spots within a mile range. And then we'd go back to our room, change, and then run down to the beach. Whatever reef break was breaking the best at that time. Taking all the waves that you've ever drawn on the back of your notebook and putting them within a mile radius of each other, so you can just walk to anyone that you want, depending on the mood that you want to surf. we'd been here for about a week, 8 days or so, and then the swell was on the decrease, and we, Ross and I, paddled out early before anyone else had paddled out, and we were just training off waves. We were surfing the super sick left. Everyone got a wave, and it was my turn, and the first wave of the set came, and I was paddling super hard, and air dropped all the way to the bottom. And then when I bounced, my hand slipped off, and I ran into the lip, and then it pushed me straight to the reef. So I went in, and Cameron took me to the emergency room where I had to get some stitches. And now I can't surf for 2 weeks.
Thinking like this. Why don't throw in frisbees at the sun? Put my soul between the bone. Now I'm running down drunk. Now I'm running like a flaming pig.
Oh yeah.
Scraping off the attitude. Old man eating all the
room to let it all get loose.
Shotgunner was probably the heaviest contest I've ever been in. It was pretty much suicide out there. Just dry reefs sticking out everywhere with 8 feet thick waves breaking onto a dry ledge, and you just had to go for it. It was really hard because the waves were like the luck of the draw. If you got lucky, you'd get a sick barreling wave. If you were unlucky, you'd get a wave breaking on dry reefs. So everyone just had to go out there and just go for it. There was no time to think, you just had to catch whatever came to you. But it was definitely the heaviest waves I've ever surfed.
Pandang!
Can you feel a little love? Curse or shame upon the universe. It knows its lines, it's well rehearsed. It sucked you in, it dragged you down to where there is no hallowed ground, where holiness is never found. Paying debt to karma, your body for a living. What you take won't kill you, but careful what you're giving.
Friends, have you got any friends? Are you rocking on? Rock on! Were you at the Indy? I was, and I was rocking, bro, rocking.
Mitch launches a big ARS off the top of that gnarly dude.
That's sick. Where'd you get that uniform from?
Have a good day.
Yeah. Sweet.
See this mirror? This mirror loves us, Stoker. Never met a mirror that didn't love us. Daniel Junior High School Rat Tail. Those who've been inflicted by the powers of the Daniel Junior High School Rat Tail definitely know the fury that it unleashes upon the flesh. I've seen numerous victims taken to the hospital. I've seen countless women, children running scared to the hills. I've seen grown men with pubic hair go to the hospital for stitches. I'll just show you a little bit of the wrath. Amoxicillina para los roches, para los enfermos, para los secret spatos de los South Americos. Okay, hold on. With a good rat tail, you always gotta make sure to get your distance right. And although I look like a skilled technician here, you can never truly master the rat's tail, because when rolled correctly, this thing has a life of its own. Watch out, Stoker. Here it comes. Amoxicillina. La Punta Goya!
Now go back on.
You son of a...
Please visit us at nofriends.com.
Bodyboarding magazine rules, dude. Bodyboarding magazine, making fools of ourselves so you don't have to.